Fresh tensions erupt between two of the world's largest economies. China denounces the U.S. for shooting down its giant balloon accused of engaging in espionage. The Chinese Defense Ministry calls the move an obvious overreaction. It adds it reserves the right to use necessary means to deal with similar situations. U.S. President Joe Biden confirmed he gave the orders to shoot down the balloon off the coast of South Carolina over what U.S. authorities called Beijing's unacceptable violation of American sovereignty. But China has insisted the balloon was a civilian research vessel blown off course.
Europe further punishing Russia over its invasion of Ukraine. The continent on Sunday imposed a ban on Russian diesel fuel and other refined oil products. This follows an oil price cap announced by the Group of Seven Nations last week. The European Union had been the largest importer of oil from Russia. It is now expected to find new supplies of diesel from the U.S., the Middle East, and India. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now with our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Here are the latest stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community.
We begin with U.S. President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris meeting with members of the Congressional Black Caucus to push for police reform following the death of Tyre Nichols at the hands of the Memphis police.
My hope is this dark memory spurs some action that we've all been fighting for.
The death of Tyre Nichols is yet another example of why we do need action. But you've already led on the action that we've been able to take through executive order. We need your help to make sure we can get the legislative actions that are necessary to save lives and to make public safety the priority that it needs to be for all communities.
Since bipartisan efforts to reach an agreement on police legislation stalled more than a year ago, Biden issued an executive order named after George Floyd, who also died at the hands of police back in 2020. Biden and Harris say no executive action can substitute for federal legislation. And Horsford says they will work with their colleagues on both sides of the aisle in both the Senate and the House to act fast on police reform. Meanwhile, the ribbon-cutting ceremony officially opened the Bohol Circle Immigrant Park in Alameda, California. Considered to be the first park in the U.S. to be named after a Filipino-American community organization, Bohol Circle.
The name that the Recreation Parks Commission selected and the City Council unanimously approved was Bohol Circle Immigrant Park.
Democratic Congresswoman Barbara Lee, who represents California's 12th district, praised the Bohol Circle organization and the contributions of Filipinos to the Bay Area.
Let's take this opportunity, though, to really celebrate the rich history and culture and traditions of the Filipino community. Everything that our Filipino community has brought to this country, especially here in the East Bay and in the vibrant city of Alameda.
According to the Philippine American National Historic Society, Bohol Circle is the oldest Filam organization in the U.S. The organization was formed in 1936 by immigrants from Bohol, Philippines.
Families throughout history have been chosen to make this decision.
And finally, in entertainment news, Filipino-American actor Dave Bautista stars as Leonard, a man tasked to lead a group of people taking on a life-altering responsibility in M. Night Shyamalan's new mystery thriller Knock at the Cabin.
Well, my first impression was, well, God, this is a lot of dialogue. But then my overall impression was this was the role that I've been searching for my whole career, because I've had a chip on my shoulder to prove myself as an actor and always said that I wanted to be an actor, not a movie star. And this was kind of my chance to prove that, you know, to make that a true statement. And so I just thought this was the role that I'd been searching for my whole career.
Bautista has always been proud of his Filipino roots and shared that he recently connected with Phil-Am comedian Jokoy.
I got a blast out from Jokoy the other day about my new film, and I was like so excited about it. Yeah, because Joe, I've never met Joe, but I've always been such a big fan. We just like recently started following each other on Instagram, but I look forward to meeting him. So, yeah.
That would be like the...
I need the network. I know, I want to do a film with Joe. I think I feel like that's meant to be.
And those are the top stories amongst the Filipino community in North America. You can catch more of our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.